Hi, today we will see about the working of a hash map according to Java 8 implementation. So it is based on the hashing principle. So Java has certain implementation and on the hash map, and we will see about the get and put method that is being used in hash map. So the question comes, how does hashing helps in storing and retrieving the value in hash map? So we will look about the storing and retrieving, that is about the get and about the put method. So hash map stores the object as entry instance, that is, it has a class called entry. It makes the instance of that, not as a key and value pair. So other thing is that hash map has inner class called entry class, and this is the entry class with values as key, value, next and hash. These are the four things, that is key, value and pointer to the next node, and the hash value as a hash of the key, which is being passed as the entry. So input, not we are sending key and value, and internally the entry part is being calculated with key, value, next and hash, and it acts as a node. So with entry node, that is key1, key2 and key3, we are having three entities. So when we talk about putting first value, that is the node with key1, value1, next1 and hash1 as the basic parameters. So initially hash code is calculated, and based upon that hash code the bucket index is found. So here, as you can see, the 4 is the index of bucket. So it is this node, that is the key1, value1, next1 and hash1 as a perimeter. This node will go to the bucket with index as 4. So in this way other nodes will be put in the hash map, and depending upon the hash code and the index will be calculated. So and here it will go to the fourth index of the bucket, that is a bucket with the index as 4, and it will be stored as a node in form of linked list. So 4 bucket will point to this particular node. Similarly, the second node, that is the node with key as key2, will be put in the hash map, and it depending upon the hash code the index of the bucket will be found. So as you can see, that second key has an index of 1, so it will be stored in the first index bucket with the first index. Similarly, third key will also come, and suppose if the third key has the same index, that is index 4, then in this scenario two nodes, that is the two entry instance, will have the same bucket, and that is a bucket index. So in this scenario a collision happens. We call this in terms of hash map as the collision in hash map, where two nodes will point to the same bucket, and it will be a scenario of collision. So here the collision is happening. So what will happen in this scenario of collision? This second key, that is the key with perimeter as key3, will be the next of key1. So it will be stored in the form of linked list, and it will be pointing next to the other nodes, whatever it comes after that. So in this scenario, this key1, key3 and other, whenever the other nodes will come, it will keep on increasing, and this scenario will increase maybe to the higher extent. So before Java 8 till Java 7, nodes used to come and nodes were keep on increasing and increasing. So whenever data is being fetched from these particular nodes, so it takes a lot of time. So recent implementation has been done in Java 8, that is, these whenever certain threshold comes and this linked list keeps on increasing, and after that particular threshold it gets transformed in some other form. And the other form which is being used in Java 8 is the red black tree. So implementation is done where when data increase from a particular extent, it gets transformed to red black tree in Java 8. This is the main changes which has been done in Java 8 regarding the implementation of hash map. So now we will see about the get method of, and in the get method we will pass the key, and depending upon the key hash code will be calculated. So suppose if you are talking about the key 1, and depending on the hash code index of the bucket is found, and the pointer goes to that particular index and it searches the that particular node which has the value according to the key given in the by the user. So it will check whether the hash code, that is hash 1, matches with that hash code or not. If it matches, then it will check the key. So when the key and hash code both matches, then the value, that is value 1, will be returned to the particular user. So first the hash code is checked and then key is checked and the value is returned to the user. In this way the get method works. So there are certain factors, or you can say certain things, which a user or a developer should know, and these factors are, that is, the maximum size to which a hash map can expand is 2 to the power 30. That is the number which is shown on the screen. And default initial capacity is 16. That is from 0 index to the index 15. That is the total size is 16, which I talked initially about. And the load factor is 0.75. That is when initially when you will multiply 0.75 with 16, it will be 12. So whenever 12 buckets get filled, the size of the bucket increases. So index of the null key is always 0. So hashmap stores null key. So whenever null key is present, it will get stored in the first bucket only, that is bucket with index 0. So these were the things which we talked about. If you like the video, please subscribe. Thank you all.